Hey, this is PWG at FBC, bringing you some spiritual vision for your life's mission. And we are continuing on this blog with the theme of the armor of God, kind of tagging along this theme of basking in the sun, facing the glory of God and standing in the sun. But we got to stand with the armor of God. There are seven of them, seven armor we to be dressed with. We talked about the belt of truth. Everything we do in life begins with truth. But we are going to embark in this blog here on the second armor that we're going to talk about. We enjoyed a wonderful communion and partook of the shed blood and broken body of Christ, reminding us that we are to dress in this salvation story that Christ has died to give us life. And as we ensure that our clothing are wrinkle-free when dressed physically, we equally need to be wrinkle-free in our spiritual armor dress code as followers of Christ. So the message highlighted the second armor, which is the breastplate of righteousness, a breastplate to protect us from the dagger of the enemy, the temptations, and the evil of this world. Yes, righteousness is what God desires from every one of us. It says in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 3 and 4, for though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God, and he pulls down all the strongholds of the enemy that comes against us. So we were encouraged, how do we tie this together? Because yes, righteousness is what God desires. And as we are in Black History Month, we learn that way back in Genesis chapter 15, verse 13, the people of Israel were also subjugated to slavery. Here's what it says. Then the Lord said to them, know for certain that 400 years your descendants will be strangers in a country, not of their own, and that they will be enslaved and mistreated there. 400 years sounds very familiar to our own black story of enslavement of a diaspora. And yet the word is not slave in the Bible, because there's no such word except for the word in Hebrew, abad. Abad means service. And Israel was subjugated to slavery or service to their enemies because of disobedience to God. We jump to the New Testament. Jesus shows up. He gives us hope. And now he wants to enslave us again. But this time, he wants to enslave us with righteousness. And Romans chapter 6, verse 18, it says thus. It says, but God be thanked that we were the servants of sin. The NIV says slaves of sin. The King James said servants. And later on it says, but being made free from sin, we became the servants of righteousness, or the slaves of righteousness in the NIV. Slave is a man-made definition of a person who is legally the property of another. So God's definition against this comparison is he wants to own us as property. For whom the Son of God has set free is free indeed. And that's John chapter 8, verse 36. So the word for slave in the King James and NIV comparative of servanthood is doulo. And the word doulo means to serve. And I want you to become a doulo owned by God as you wear your blessed plate of righteousness. Ensure it is wrinkle free. Maranatha, even so. Come, Lord Jesus. Hey, check us out at www.fbctoronto.ca.